Our tool combines BI capabilities with textual data search. With it, you can explore your quantitative data and dig into unstructured documents. For whatever BI data you're looking at, you also see its most relevant documents. Our graph-based interface is optimized for tablets. It's already in productive use in the city of Antibes. What's more, our tool will be open sourced. In this demo, we connect to SAP BO and a file share. Imagine we're working for a city and there are budget restrictions. The mayor needs a tool to take action. Before our demo, let's check the tools that the mayor had. First, the BI tool. I want to see the budget per branches. Well, I do have SAP BO and I can search for related reports. Yet I need to know that the reports exist, and I usually receive them as PDFs, which are not interactive. Second, my document management tool. I want to see the budget-related documents. Since my employees store their files on the share, I open my Windows Explorer. But I end up with many folders, such as these, with no idea where to start from, or worse, with folders which seem to be the right ones, but which are empty. It's a nightmare. Now, let's see how the mayor does with our software. So, while I'm launching the application, what's happening behind the scenes? We have a connection to the SAP Business Object system, and we are retrieving the complete dataset. Yes, the complete dataset. Tablets have so much RAM now that most use cases can fit into it, and the processing power is way sufficient. We have actually optimized the software for tablets because it's the thing managers like to use nowadays. The application focuses first on the city root node. The main screen on the left shows all the city entities available, and clicking them replaces the drill down you have on BI software. When clicking on a city department, let's say human resources, I can see its related entities as children of the node. Look now on the right. I can see many analytics information, such as the number of employees, their categories, their department, and all of this information are computed recursively. In a moment, we'll discover also that the right panel cares about the most relevant documents. Going back to our scenario, let's see which department is the most budget-consuming. Looking at the finance subtree, we will soon see that the IT department is among the winners. Let's dig into the finance node. Notice that you can play with the graph nodes, which are able to automatically position themselves. Not sure though that it will make you dream as developers though, but anyway. For each subnode, we check on the pie chart on the right to see which department or entity is consuming the most budget. Iterating this process, we can see that the IT department costs a lot. And digging a bit more, guess what? The biggest license cost comes from Oracle! Yet we only have one part of the vision. We need to know what relationships we have with Oracle. It is now time to uncover the second capability of the software, textual data integration. As we said, there is more on the right side than pure analytics. Look at the bottom. The system shows me the abstract of the top two intranet documents related to my work. Although these two documents you can see in the rectangles are relevant to the Oracle software, I am interested specifically in the licensing contracts, so I need to fine-tune my document search. I have two options. I can either click here, and I access to a modern search user interface with facets, autocomplete, suggestions, whatever you can dream of. But I can also click there, and I get a graph-based search. This view triggers live the search engine and retrieves the data in milliseconds. Now, how do I browse and look for what I want? My root node is the keyword I'm currently searching for. The next nodes are the categories through which I can refine my search. We have here file types, dates, and data sources. I'm looking for a PowerPoint about Oracle. Let's go. We click on it and voila. We have only PowerPoints talking about it. I think this PowerPoint is exactly what we're looking for.